Hi, this is a special video for Patrick Foster, who donated the channel, not once, but twice. Thank you, my dear Patrick. Thank you. As for you, my dear, please send him one huge kiss. Well, this is an answer on your question. As for the others, let me just read your comment and then I'm going to tell you what to do and how to do that. You should make video about removing fuel gauge sending unit to look inside and check condition of fuel tank. I had this issue, poor fuel supply, where filter screen was clogged, causing issues like loud fuel pump, random rough running and stalling, and impossible to get a steady duty cycle reading. And then, of course, thank you for your videos. Thank you for your donations. At first, concerning this matter, you cannot just remove the fuel gauge sending unit on half a tank, let's say. Your tank must be empty. That's a precondition for this task. And of course, after 30 years, then every strainer should be removed and cleaned. Not just the strainer, maybe the fuel tank, but you must beware of that it's at the back. Fuel tank, it's running all the width of the car. It's behind the rear seat. And well, now let's go step by step. The condition of the fuel tank. Okay, as for the condition of the fuel tank, every fuel tank gets clogged and it's dirty after 30 years. And as I could remember, you're the one that has that 190E. That hasn't been running for a while. If you have ever or I don't know where, anywhere, bought any car, not just 190E, any of these cars, W124, 126, no matter, any of these Ke-Jetronic cars, that, and I must stress this, that haven't been running for years, then it's a must to remove the fuel tank and to clean it. Because now we go further. Poor fuel supply where filter screen was clogged, causing issues like loud fuel pump. Once I've been talking about that, once the fuel pump starts hearing loud, then it's gone. Then you must replace the fuel pump. The fuel pump can be dead, let's say like that, is number one, running out of fuel. And number two, driving on reserve. Don't ever drive on reserve. Remember, all the dirt falls down. And this is my appeal, and this is my most sincere advice to you. The very moment you see the lamp on your car, on your gauge that goes on, go to the gas station and tank your car. Because, as I told you, all the dirt and debris collects at the bottom. And as you run, you have the first filter, and that's the strainer. That filter is going to collect that debris, and then it's going to go into the fuel pump, and then through the fuel pump in the fuel filter. So you will have to then take off both the strainer, replace the fuel pump as well as the fuel filter. If you want to avoid this, if you decide to check your fuel pump, I've been talking about that, I will put you the card here. Go somewhere where you have that big jack and lift the car up. As you do, then take off the lid where the fuel pump, the fuel filter, as well as the fuel accumulator are located. And then run the car. At first, run the car and listen to the pump. If you hear the pump literally like this, bzzz, replace the pump. That's the clear sign that your fuel pump is gone. It can still supply. It can still supply fuel, but you have to be aware that you have a bad fuel pump. Then you will have these issues because of the strainer that has clogged, and then because of the bad fuel pump that is not able to deliver, to supply the fuel we need in our cylinders. And now, as for the pump, if you want to test it, this is the fuel pressure regulator. Look, imagine that here is that line from the fuel distributor. This one is the differential pressure line, and this one is the line out. So here, as you see, you just unscrew that return line. You can put a hose on. You can take it, you can put it here, and then find a hose clamp and tighten it here, and on the other side of the hose find some bottle, some 2-liter bottle. You can find anyone, but let it be clean. Wash it, clean it, so because of the gasoline that you're going to pour back into the fuel tank again. As you have done it, then start the car, because we want to see what our pump does under load. That's important. Don't be afraid because of the fuel distributor. The fuel distributor is going to have enough fuel for the idle. Just don't press accelerator, nothing, or the sensor plate, no. Just do this, and then measure the time of 1 minute. or let's say to 40 seconds. In 40 seconds, if you get less than 1 liter, just throw the pump away, replace it. I haven't tested my strainer because as I measured once upon a time my fuel pressures, I got 5.9 bars row pressure and 5.5 bar secondary pressure, so the working pressure. And then I know that my fuel pump is good. It's new, it's brand new. But maybe one day I decide to see the condition of my strainer. If you want to check it, it's located under the right passenger wheel. You're gonna find it. You cannot miss it. You will need the
socket.
46 millimeters you need for this. But again, I must stress this. At first, empty your fuel tank. And then, as you do, then check the condition of your strainer. Be very careful with it. At first, wash it somehow. You can even wash it in the ultrasonic bath. You don't have to buy the new one. If it gets ruptured during the process, then buy the new one. That's everything I can tell. Because it's the first filtration directly from the fuel tank. But if you want to preserve any fuel pump, just don't drive on reserve. Never, never ever. Then your strainer is gonna be clean. Then your fuel filter is gonna last longer and your fuel pump is going to last longer and you're not gonna make it bad. Well,
Patrick,
I think I've managed to answer your question. This is the video, so the point of your demand is just to unscrew the return line, put some other hose here, you can attach it here and then tighten it with a hose clamp. There, that's everything I can tell you. Again, thank you for your donations. I appreciate it. And as for all of you, if you have acquired some bents from this era, and if it hasn't been running for a couple of years, then this is the must to wash the fuel tank. And as for the others that have been driving their cars on the regular basis, after 30 years, you can also check your fuel pumps. And your fuel pumps at first, and then your strainer. That's it. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing!